Steve Steiger and I are here at Memorial Church at Stanford University. Steve, what marks 2003 and Mem Chu?
Well, it's the centennial of the dedication of the church, which was in January of 1903.
And tell me, there have been some births and rebirths of this particular building.
Well, yeah, again, the building was begun construction in 1899, and the dedication was in 1903. But just 2 years later, in 1906, there was the earthquake, which severely damaged the building. The original building had a spire which fell down into the church and blew out the front facade, destroying the mosaics that we see behind us. The church was rebuilt beginning in 1908 and rededicated again in 1913. However, many years later, in 1989, once again, earthquakes were not kind to the church, and there was another severe case of damage, and another $10 million restored the church to its present condition.
Well, speaking of the condition, the mosaics outside are absolutely spectacular. There must be some history to those.
Well, yeah, they were designed and built by a firm in Venice, Italy. The proprietor of the firm had befriended the Stanfords at the time of Leland Stanford Jr.'s death when he died in Italy in 1884. Mrs. Stanford, when she decided to create the church in memory of her husband, hired the firm to design the original mosaics. And they were designed and put together in Italy, shipped over here along with some workmen who put them on the building. When the 1906 earthquake came about and destroyed them, once again the church was rebuilt using the same mosaic craftsmen from Italy, and they recreated, though not exactly the same, pattern on the church building.
So, describe to me, what exactly is a mosaic?
Mosaic is a small series of small pieces of glass or tile that are put together to create a pattern, a picture, if you will.
Well then, if we're talking about small pieces of tile, then we're talking about hundreds of workmen, aren't we?
Well, we're probably talking about dozens of workmen in Italy over a long period of time, several years, to put the patterns together, and then several workmen were brought over here to California, and they spent another 2 years or so putting the patterns back up on the walls here at the church.
Are there other stories about the church, the interior, for example, or some of those fabulous stained glass windows that we would hear about through the Palo Alto Historical Association?
Yeah, we have some information on it, and there are actually several excellent booklets published by Stanford that would describe the church, the glass, stained glass windows, the four organs that are in the church, as well as other attributes of the church.
You said four organs?
That's my understanding. There are now four organs. The original one, and then they've keep added them every couple of years.
And how would I get more information?
Come by and see us at the History Desk at the Palo Alto Main Library, or look for the Stanford University Bulletin on the church.
Super. Thanks so much, Steve.
You're welcome.